nog wat dat nog nodig.
Dag, Lidder.
Wat nou dat er met dat nou?
Haast, dat is dat. Dat is dan al. Nee, leg dat dan. Hallo, dat is
ah, dat is lekker. Dat is dan
het. Ja, dat
is dat. Ja, why is it got our brother there? We're going to play there. Don't play there. It's
our brother there. That's all. I don't know. I don't do that.
I'm done. Brother there. The brother. Don't play there.
No, no, no. I'm not enough.
But the brother there. I'm done now. I ain't playing there. I'm going to be done. I'm going to go.
So,
no, I'm done.
So, I'm done. So, I'm done. I'm
done.
Så, vad det är, vad det är, det är bara av det är fel med det här.
No, that's not right. Tack bara, tack bara.
Ha, där det, där var det det där. Tack, tack det där.
Bara. Ja, där då.
Här är det där. Wow, wow, det blir det där, jag vet inte.
Där då. Tack det där, tack det där, där där där.
Wow, 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 wow.
Again.
Following Cornwall's demands for the same status as Scotland and Ireland, the government has agreed to close down their industries as well.
Buckingham Palace this week issued a series of strongly worded denials just in case anything had happened that they might not have heard about.
Prince Charles' tour of India, and a Buckingham Palace spokesman has revealed that despite his hectic schedule, His Royal Highness still managed to get in some Christmas shopping. Top of the list was a new stable lad for Princess Anne.
How old are you, son?
17.
And the young lady, is she 16?
Not yet. In about 10 minutes.
Choke on your turkey and your Christmas tree falls down. I hope your mother-in-law comes to stay when your telly is on the blink. It's off, you stingy git, stingy git. It's off, you stingy git. God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing to dismay. Lord Jesus Christ, our Saviour, was born on Christmas Day to save poor souls from
Daddy, what are you doing here?
Hello, Johnny. I just came to check you're asleep.
Oh, I'm so excited about Father Christmas, I can't sleep.
Oh, yes, well, you better, otherwise he might not come, might he?
Oh, he wouldn't do that, would he, Daddy? He loves me, doesn't he, Dad?
Yes, yes, he does. Now, go back to sleep.
Right.
Good night.
What's that big bag you're carrying?
Oh, this?
Yes.
It's a rubbish bag. I'm taking the rubbish out for your mother.
Oh. That looks like a full packet of nuts in the top of there.
Yes. Your mother must have thrown them away by mistake.
Oh. Can I have it?
Yes, why not? Well, look, put them under your pillow and go back to sleep. Good night.
What's that big box in there?
This must be the box that the Christmas crackers came in.
Oh, it's a pretty one. Can I have it?
No, go to sleep.
Oh, please. Please, Daddy, it's Christmas.
No.
Please, Daddy.
Shh. Look, sister. Here.
Oh, look, it's not empty. It's a telecomputer game.
Is it? Is it?
Yes. Can I have a look through the rubbish?
No. Go to sleep. Go to sleep.
I don't think Mummy would be very pleased if she knew you'd been in here with the big bag of rubbish and spoilt all the fun of Christmas morning. Now, would she? If you get my meaning, I think you do.
Yes. Yes, right. But look, there's nothing left in there, is there? It's completely empty.
Yes, there is. What's that round thing?
It's an old balloon.
It feels like a football.
No, it's an old balloon.
Well, let's ask Jennifer. Jennifer!
No! Shh! Yes, it's a football. It's a football. There. There. Now, go to sleep, you little scug.
Oh, and there's some more nuts. Oh, look, and some licorice. That's Jennifer's favourite. Oh, thank goodness you didn't throw that out. There's not much left in there now. The rest of it is just the sort of unimaginative rubbish you'd expect to find in Christmas stockings these days, so you might as well throw it out.
You little...
Oh, I'm so looking forward to the morning to see what Father Christmas has brought me. Mummy promised me she thought it would be a lot this year, and it better be, or else I could make things very uncomfortable for Granny with her little problem, if you know what I mean. Because I did like all those golf clubs that you bought for your cousin Charles, and the bicycle that you bought for Jennifer, if you get my meaning.
Yes.
Oh, Daddy, don't you just love Christmas?
I've been on this program 15 months, I mean. I've done every single goddamn program, you know. And I think it's awful. And I'll tell you why it's awful. I'll tell you why it's awful. Because there's a woman in it. I'm not saying which one she is. No names, no pack drill me or something. But there's a woman in it. And women, they're so ambitious, aren't they? It's frightening. And you see, the thing is, they don't want to stay at home anymore. They want to go out and they want to tow 5-ton tractors out there these days. Well, I tell you, I've never seen a woman tow a 5-ton tractor in my life. I've never seen a man tow a 5-ton tractor. Kind of think of it, I've never seen a 5-ton tractor. So I'll be much good here, even. But they want to have their cake and eat it. These days, women, they want to have their cake and eat it. And they expect us to bake the bloody cake as well, I've noticed that. But women, they're everywhere now, but beware of them. In Russia, 80% of tank commanders are women. In France, 45% of men are women.
There you are, you see. Another example of blatant sexism on television. The woman once again portrayed as a sex object.
No, I'm sorry, but I can't agree with you.
I mean, it's almost as if there is a conspiracy on the part of program makers to insinuate that a woman's not acceptable, either on television or in real life, unless she's physically appealing to men.
Well, I'm sorry, but I can't allow you to exaggerate like this. I mean, I can't see that the television presses women through sex stereotyping. Women have infinitely more free will. They have infinitely more ability over their own destiny to control themselves than the Marxist portrait of a wax mold awaiting the next received media impression gives them credit for.
Surely you would agree that compared to the women, there are very, very few attractive men on television.
Now, television is a visual medium. I think this idea that there's some sort of lascivious conspiracy on the part of program makers to ogle fetching ladies on our television screens all night is just a load of cock and bull. I mean, you're an attractive woman. Are you telling me that you're not?
Darling, I do wish you wouldn't bring your work home with you.
Lot 34. Lot Lahominy. Do I hear 3,000, 3,000, 3,000?
The Soviet Union and the Moscow branch of the Mickey Mouse Club today held its annual general meeting.
Kenya. And with more and more people wanting to join the police force, the authorities have decided to select only those who are over 7 feet tall.
Concerned at the growing number of schoolgirls becoming pregnant, the government have started a campaign which shows children the best way to avoid conception.
It just proves how blind and stupid Dennis and his party are. You know, I wonder if you know anything about economics at all.
Mr. Robbins, your view.
Well, now that Michael has allowed me to get a word in, I have to say I've never heard such rubbish. And to think that this man is in the government is quite frightening.
I resent that snide remark. It's exactly the kind of thing I have come to expect from your kind of politician.
My kind of politician. If only the public knew to what depth some people will stoop when they enter the house.
This is the kind of politician who will be greatly missed.
A great parliamentarian of our time and a close personal friend. I am heartbroken.
George, you see, Julie and I have a very open marriage. I honestly think that's the only way it can be if you work in London.
No, I could never have that kind of relationship, could you?
Sure, yeah.
We have a very open marriage.
Very, very open relationship. Mm.
What, do you have affairs with other women?
Sure, yeah. I mean, I'm not saying Sorry.
I was just going to say that if he wants to sleep with other women, that's okay with me, and I'm sure it's the same the other way around.
Oh, sure. I mean, if she wants to sleep with other women, that's okay.
But you do come back together again in the end.
Look, George, if Sue wants to sleep...
Sarah.
Sorry?
I'm Sarah.
Sarah, sorry, love.
You two that do live together, don't you?
Well, not exactly in the same place, no, but I mean...
It's no hassle getting to Norwich.
You live in Norwich?
No, Jonathan lives in Norwich.
Chester.
You live in Chester? You moved?
No, I'm Chester, not Jonathan.
Excuse me, have you two ever met each other before?
Look, it's a meeting. It seems just an old-fashioned kind of concept, really. I think if you love somebody, then knowing them isn't really that important, is it?
read all the way through this. I'll start, okay? The wealth of those societies in which the capitalist mode of production prevails presents itself as an immense accumulation of commodities, its unit being a single commodity. Our investigation must therefore begin with the analysis of a commodity. A commodity is, in the first place, an object outside us. A thing... Oh, sod it, let's go and kill someone.
Ronald Reagan has emphatically denied that his luxuriant red hair is dyed and added that it was that colour when he bought it.
The record industry, and number one in the Iranian top 40 this week, is Ayatollah Khomeini's version of Underneath the Spreading Chestnut Tree. Pope John Paul, once again attacking the use of contraceptives, was today pictured demonstrating the rhythm method.
And now, let us all say the Apostles' Creed, as contained in the New Revised Version of the New Revised Version of the Book of Common Prayer, or meditation, it's the same thing, really. I believe in God.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, or at least it stands to reason there has to be some sort of greater power, you know, like electricity sort of thing. And in Jesus Christ, who was obviously a fantastic bloke, and it's been proved historically that he actually did exist around that time, actually, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary. No, don't laugh. It could happen. After all, they can do it in a test tube these days. I mean, that proves it, doesn't it? The third day, he rose again from the dead. A sort of reincarnation, if you like. Did you see that program on BBC Two? I believe in the Holy Ghost, telepathy, flying saucers, black magic. There must be something in astrology, gay liberation, the Loch Ness Monster, the abominable snowman, the Surrey Panther, copper bracelets for rheumatism, levitation, water divining, poltergeists, and the life everlasting. That is, if the bloody Russians don't invade Poland. Amen.
A hideous wailing and a gnashing of teeth, and the air was filled with smoke and flame.
Well, I'll tell you if your clutch has gone, mate.
Cliche, nothing.